Let us study about potentiometer. About potentiometer, we can write that it is an experimental setup to measure potential difference across two terminals, any two terminals of a circuit with high accuracy. Here we are mentioning high accuracy because in the previous section we have studied that when voltmeter is used to measure potential difference, it draws some current due to which accuracy is relatively low. So for potentiometer here we are writing it is an experimental setup to measure potential difference across two terminals of a circuit with high accuracy, and we can add without drawing any current from the source for measurement. Like for measurement of potential difference, a voltmeter draws some current, whereas in case of potentiometer at the time of measurement of potential difference, it never draws any current from the source. That's why its accuracy is very high. Let's now start with the study of working or setup of a potentiometer. In general about the potentiometer, we can write that a potentiometer consists of two circuit sections in its setup, and these circuit sections are, the first one is called primary circuit, which is actually called the known parameter part of circuit. This is basically a part of potentiometer circuit setup in which all parameters of the circuit are known. These are called primary circuit, and the second one is, we can also write part of circuit of potentiometer. The second one we can write is secondary circuit. This is basically called measurement part of potentiometer circuit. In this section, we connect those terminals of circuit or different kind of potential difference which are to be measured, and this part of potentiometer circuit is called secondary circuit. So from the next section, we are going to discuss in detail about both of these circuits of the potentiometer setup. And on the next sheet, I am going to explain you about the basic setup of the potentiometer circuit. Let us study about the potentiometer setup. In a potentiometer setup, we first take a very long straight wire. It is generally a wire of 10 meter in length. I'll also tell you how a length of 10 meter wire is accommodated in a laboratory setup. Now say if there's a wire of length 10 meter, on one side of the wire we connect a battery accumulator of which the battery EMF EB is known to us. This is also called accumulator EMF in primary circuit. And we connect a rheostat here along with an emitter. This emitter and rheostat combination helps us to maintain a constant current in this wire, which we term as a potentiometer wire. Here in a realistic experiment, if the battery goes down, if it is discharged, the current through the potentiometer wire decreases, and as soon as the reading of emitter falls, we slightly decrease the value of a rheostat resistance to maintain the constant current in the potentiometer wire. And this section of circuit we call primary circuit, in which every parameter is known to us, that is battery EMF or current flowing in the potentiometer wire or the length of potentiometer wire. And on the other side of this potentiometer wire, we connect the potential difference or EMF to be measured. This is the unknown EMF which we wish to measure. Here another advantage which you just keep in mind that by using a potentiometer setup, we can also measure EMFs because at the time of measurement, it does not draw any current. Whereas using a voltmeter, you can never measure any EMF because EMF is the open circuit potential difference. And whenever you connect a voltmeter across an EMF, it draws some current. So anyway, let's get back to the situation we are discussing. Here the EMF is connected with a galvanometer along with the solid piece of metal which is called a jockey, and it is termed denoted by the symbol J. Now it is just a solid metal piece because it is kept just to be connected at various points of this wire so that we can find out the deflection in galvanometer when the jockey is connected to different points. We'll discuss in detail about the working of the system, but this part of circuit in which there is an unknown EMF which is to be measured or any unknown potential difference which is to be measured, connected in series with a galvanometer and terminated at a jockey. Now this part of circuit we call secondary circuit of the potentiometer wire, and this is the whole setup of potentiometer. Now before proceeding with the complete details and working mechanism of this potentiometer, let's first discuss the realistic setup. If we talk about a realistic lab setup of a potentiometer, here you can see the picture. This picture gives you an idea about the actual lab setup of a potentiometer. Here you can see a 10 meter wire is placed on a wooden board, and there are 10 wire pleats adjoining to each other, and the terminals are connected alternative to each other so that between terminals A and B, you can see in this situation the total wire length is 10 meter, and a scale is also connected adjoining to these parallel wires to measure the length from any terminal to any point of the wire. And now on one side of this potentiometer wire, you can see we connect an accumulator battery along with a rheostat and an ammeter. And on the other side, we connect again, say a battery of a known EMF along with a galvanometer and a jockey. This is the whole setup which we generally use in laboratory. And from the next section, we'll discuss about the complete analysis and working as well as mathematical calculations related to a potentiometer.